Welcome dear students to our technofund.kvs YouTube channel. This YouTube channel consists of various videos related to the subject of computer of class 8th standard. The first topic, as you can see on the screen, is of our database concepts. Now, what are database concepts and how we have to use it, we need to understand in this chapter. So let us now discuss about database concepts. Before discussing into database concept, we need to understand that what is the meaning of the term data. Basically, data can be defined as the raw facts, figures, numbers, which does not hold any meaning in general, but are very useful to store some data about any real world practical entity. This can also be understood well with the help of an example, as you can see on the screen. Here we have a student, and as we know that every student has some of its basic characteristics, properties or details. Like a student has admission number in school, name, date of birth, mother's name, email, class, section, mobile number, blood group and many more other data, other details. So we can also say that these all are the things we can term as the data, because if we see the admission number of a school, that what is the value of an admission number of a child? So admission number of a child is in value, integer or a number. And likewise, we say that what is the type of value we have in name field. So what is the value here? Name in character or strings, we can have the name, as well as date of birth consists of numbers as well as some special characters. Mother's name, email, class also contains various types of numbers, characters, symbols, etc. So here it is the data. So data defines any real world practical entity, but in itself it does not hold any meaning. Likewise, if we take an example of a person who is working in a company of an employee, so an employee consists of an employee number, a name, employee name, post, salary, department and many more. Likewise, we can take another example also, that of a player. Player has a particular game, player itself has a name, his experience, number of matches, record, many achievements. Likewise, we have the various data. So data describes any real practical entity around us. Just like we see the example of account to understand the concept of data. Everybody has an account in a bank. So bank allot us a particular account number, name of the account holder, date of birth, father's name, mother's name, mobile number and other various KYC documents. So all these are again describing what? The data related to a real world entity. So this is about the data, and the collection of data, or we can say the collection of meaningful data, is result into the information. So information is very, very important to us, as we all know that we need information in this age of information technology. Therefore, we must need to understand the concept data. Hope you all understand the concept of data. Now let us come to the next topic of database. Now, as we just discussed earlier, that we need a database or the collection of data of various real world entities, like in like of students in a school, like of employees in a company, like of patients in a hospital. As you can see on the screen, there are various examples, like of account holders in a bank, like the collection of websites on Google, like database of players in our team game and many more. So what is a database? A database is a place where we store huge amount of interrelated details of an object, like these examples are here. So database is a very simple term, but very important term. Now coming to our next topic of database management system. This is a very, very important topic, and we need to understand it well. As this consists of the words database management system, this can be understood as a system or a software which is used to work on the data stored in a database. So full form of DBMS is database management system, and we always have a need such kind of software through which we can easily create our data, store that data, edit that data, and delete that data as per our need and demand. There are various companies, various famous companies, which created a very popular database management systems. Like we have a famous Oracle, MySQL, MS Access, MariaDB, SQL Server, IBM DB2, MongoDB, and many more. In class 8, we will work in the package of base LibreOffice. Let us continue ahead. This is the small pic screenshot image of the LibreOffice base as you are seeing on your screen. Now, coming to work in a database, we need to understand first the concept of a table in a database. Let us understand this. What is a table and why we need it? As you can see on your screen, first of all, there is a collection of rows and columns. A table is a structure which is formed after the intersection of many rows and columns. Every intersection of row and a column is called a cell, as just in a spreadsheet or Microsoft Excel, as you know. Every table has some fields or columns, and some related data is stored in these columns. Let us understand the concept of table from the given example. As you are seeing the screen, that we are going to create a table student. We have four columns: one, admission number, name, class, section, and we have five records of five students. Every record represents one complete detail of one student. As you can see, admission number 1001 belongs to a student Raman studying in class 6th in section A. Likewise, 1004 is the admission number of the student Meera, class 8th, section C. So I hope you understand the concept of a table very well. Now let us coming ahead, the data type in a table. What is a data type? Data type is a very, very important term. As we already discussed data, that data consists of some information which is not meaningful. So first of all, we need to describe that what kind of data we are going to store in a particular column as just in a particular table. As we can see in our earlier example, like name, so we have only the alphabets, there is no number in it. Likewise, in admission number column, we have only the numbers, we don't have the alphabets. So likewise, class, we have only the numbers, not any alphanumeric characters, not any alphabets. So we need to specify that what is the data type in a table. So data type can be defined as the type of data which is to be required to be saved, or the type of values to be saved in a particular column. So every time we are going to make a table in a database, we first know that what kind of data types we have to give to our columns. So in LibreOffice, in base of the LibreOffice, there are a variety of data types which are given. As you can see on the screen, we have the text varchar. Varchar is the data type which is used to store the numeric alphabetical values and can also store the numbers. So as you can see on your screen, we have some of the popular data types which we have to work in every time in every table regarding the any real world entity. So text varchar stores the text values like alphabets or numbers or special characters. The number numeric stores only numbers or numeric values. The integer, only integer, both positive and negative. Decimal, decimal data type stores decimal values. Float also stores decimal values with a high range. We sometimes we also